Hello, you Merchant Center Mastery peeps. Welcome back to another episode of this random but totally focused on Google Merchant Center YouTube channel. So today we're going to talk about another attribute. One of the goals I have with this channel is just to give you like really helpful, here's just some helpful things to know, maybe even things that trip people up in Merchant Center. Another thing I want to do is just walk through the different attributes, the different product attributes that you'll see in the Google Shopping feed. A couple things, maybe brief admin notes on that, is just that Google does change up their attribute policies. So be aware of that. I've noticed that. I've kept an eye on policies over the years, and I have seen certain attributes where they adjust things. And one example is Google product category. They used to have it required. It's no longer required and all that. So it is helpful to review what, you know, where things are at with these attributes, but just be aware that Google does change these things over time. In that way, what I want to do in these attribute videos is to give you some like basic definitions of them, some basic information. Here's what you should know about Google. I also always want to just give you some helpful optimization tips. Like here are things that we've learned over the years when by managing these accounts that we've done for over a decade, you know, worked on Google Shopping. So I think Shopping's been around. I've been in PPC over a decade. I think Shopping's been around about that long now at this point. Okay, so let's hop into specifically the feed attribute product type. Now, product type, there's a few things I want you to know about this, all right? So a few things I want you to know. First of all, product type and Google product category are not the same thing, and that does trip people up, and it's kind of important to know that, and you can actually check out my videos that I've shot on Google product category, where I don't remember exactly what I said, but I'm pretty sure I maybe started it saying the exact same thing. But that is because as I've spoken at conferences and that, I have so many people who ask a question about, let's say, product type or product category, and I realize they're confusing the two of them, okay? So Google product category is a very specific, like you can only choose what Google already has selected that goes into that. So Google product category is Google's classification system. Product type attribute is your classification system. You're telling Google, here's how I see my products and their hierarchy to themselves, And so that difference is pretty important, and is actually why I wrote an article on this a while back. Google product category used to be required, and it's no longer a required attribute. And as I had conversations with Googlers specifically on that, you know, this was years ago, but I had specific conversations with Googlers on that. And one of the things one of them noted, who understood some of the you know, inner workings of the back end of Shopping Ads a little bit more, they noted that Google actually, in a really healthy way, was starting to identify that Google product category was not always as helpful in helping merchants communicate, this is actually how we classify our product. And they started to find that Google product type had more of a benefit of giving Google better information of how a merchant sees their products. And it basically gives Google contextual information about how your products work with one another and within, you know, what you see as their larger categories. And so in that way, product type is actually pretty important, not only because of that, what I just described, but actually because now Google has even, as of last year, I was watching a Google shopping, you know, just some like normal Google shopping event. And one of the things they brought out that I don't know if I'd ever heard them explicitly state to us as PPCers before, one of the things they noted is that product type actually does impact their algorithm, all right? So as they are determining how they will determine what you will bid at, in terms of like whatever you're using, PMax, or maybe you set bids with Shopping, whatever it is, part of what works into that algorithm of how they're going to determine which product shows and all that, part of that is product type. So it's important to know that. It's important to fill it out. A few things about product type, maybe some best practices, that sort of thing. So one thing that people do not realize about product type, well, let me start here. Like you've probably seen the idea of like what product type looks like. Again, that's a little why it's confusing with product category, because they actually look kind of the same, right? And Google even notes on their help doc that you can use the same category, you can use the same thing if you want for Google product category or product type. But product type is typically you start from your more general taxonomy system and you move into more specified system of categorization for what that product is. What I find is that often it is helpful to follow, you know, the main menu nav of how you classify your system. You probably have some way on your back end of already classifying your products. And this is going to kind of depend. I'm using I really like Quadlock. They're not a client, whatever. I actually just kind of like them. And so I was trying to think of someone to use as an example for this one. And I thought, I'm going to use Quadlock because I have it for my case. I have a phone case and I use it on my bike and things like that. So anyways, so like Quadlock, all right, they make like phone cases and stuff, but they make phone mounts and they do it for a variety of different applications. You can do it in the car, you can do it on the marine, you know, you're on your boat, whatever. And so, what that allows you to do with product type is to take your, you could take your menu nav system and push it into product type. Or you can even use that maybe as a starting place and then build that out, whatever you might want to do. But that's maybe a good starting place is to think of your menu nav. All right, so one thing that people don't always know is you can actually upload different values for your product type. And what I mean by that is your entire product type system. So let's say here, I'm sorry, let me go ahead and broaden all of this out here so we just get a little bit bigger so you guys can see that. So this is one product type. You can actually add in another product type, and let's just change that to spring dresses. I confess I don't even know what a maxi dress is, right? So let's say you already had like a product type going for, you know, spring dresses, and you wanted to keep that in there, but you also wanted to add in, you know, your specific product type. So maybe you upload a supplemental feed and then you attach that to a feed rule and tell Google, hey, always attach this supplemental feed product types that I've manually edited to the front of, you know, the other product types that you know, the client pushes in automatically. You know, you could do that. I'll note, this is not super common at all. So just be aware of that. Like, you're not really missing anything if you're not doing this. It's just something maybe helpful to know that product type does allow you to do. Maybe there's someone out there who actually is running into this. Now you know. You separate that by a comma, and that tells Google, hey, this is one product type system. This is another product type system. We separate those by a comma. You do not, every once in a while I see people using commas in your product type. Like, don't do that. That's not going to work. All right, you have to use these carrots for your product type. So that's one thing to know. If you do that, Google is only using this first one for your bidding and attaching into your campaign. So if you're segmenting your campaigns by product type, which I highly recommend, Google's only going to use this first one. So be aware of that. And then, you know, I noted, you know, bringing your product type into for campaign segmentation, I think that is still, I've kind of been beating this drum for years now, actually, and I think it's still this undervalued way to categorize your campaigns. And I think that it's important to see that, because if you think, again, going back to the fact that a product type should be mirroring the way that your products are already categorized. And I've always been a strong one for saying, like, your products are categorized that way for likely a reason. Like a product category often follows a specific audience. These people are interested in this sort of product, and that's different than these people who are interested in this sort of product. So for instance, that might be, you know, you have a product type for, let's say for this quad lock case and mount. And you have this, your cycling product case and mount, and you have your off-roading Toyota 4Runner TRD Pro case and mount. Those tend to be, not always, but they tend to be two different audiences, even if it's the same person, by the way, who owns both of those things. They might be in different buying cycles for them. So in some ways, they're still kind of a different in-market audience, frankly. At least that's how I see it. So I think that's a strong argument for segmenting campaigns around, like, who is interested and who's buying, which is an audience. And that's centered around, in a lot of ways, your product type, your product categories, because then you can actually create ad creative and you can show, like, even let's say PMax, I'm a big fan of segmenting out PMax campaigns, or at the very least ad groups, so asset groups. So oftentimes, what we like doing is trying PMax campaigns, maybe on more of a higher level, like historical performance of products. So we might say these products are our top performers. So we want to get those into their own campaign. But then let's say maybe there's 100 of those. How can we break those out further? We might break those asset groups within those campaigns into more of that actual product type segmentation so that we can match our audience insights with our ad assets and try to, and then that product group, that product type, and then try to force Google a little bit better with PMax, let's say, after here are the, like the Toyota TRD Pro people who are actively in market for purchasing a new phone case and mount, right? That's different than our cycling assets and ad creative and all that, and then audience who's over here, right? So I think that's a strong, I hope I've kind of made a case for why product type should be considered a little bit more for products, for campaign segmentation than I think it often is.